We're going in here just now. Here's the glottis, and here you can see the upper esophageal sphincter that we're going through, and we can see the distance to the stenosis that we've got. It's around 6 or 7 centimeters that we can go down. And I've got an XP190N. It's got an outer diameter of just under 6 millimeters. And at that thickness, I've still got some resistance as I go through. What we're planning today is to dilate it using Savory bougies, up to 12 millimeters. I'm fixing it here at my hip and grasping it very tightly so that it keeps lying in the Seldinger technique. And I'm slowly advancing the bougie over it. Here, we're injecting cortisone again. Not a miracle agent. Advance the needle. I think something's happening. It's tearing a bit here at this point. You can see these scarring traits after ESD, after circumferential ESD. But what we're doing is, you're doing it with Savory bougies. And what we want to do here is to do the bouginage with these bougie caps that we attach to the endoscope. Six caps that we have available. Here we have 3 caps from 7, 8 and 10 millimeters that we can attach to the pediatric gastroscope with a maximum working channel of 6 millimeters. Then we have another set with 12, 14 and 16 millimeters. And these are the ones that we can attach to the normal gastroscope. And here we've already got the 14 millimeter one, and what we can see here is you can introduce it very nicely. It's not really a big problem. And what we can see here at the front in the center is this hole, which is for a wire that you could lead a wire through if you wanted to.